In this class, today we discuss application of Gauss law here. Correct? So, Gauss law can be used to find electric field due to some symmetric charge distribution here. And how can we apply this Gauss law? That we will study today. Correct? So, to apply the Gauss law, what we need to do is, we will be given a symmetric charge distribution there. Then to apply the Gauss law, we need to choose or we need to take a closed surface around that charge distribution. That surface will be known as Gaussian surface, and at that Gaussian surface we will be calculating electric flux here. Then we will be using the Gauss law, that is electric flux is equal to qin upon epsilon naught, to find electric field due to that charge configuration at a given point here. Correct? So this is how we will be doing only. That now the Gaussian surface will be choosing, that will be our choice only, that has to be a closed surface, that will be taken in such a way that at all the points on the Gaussian surface the magnitude of electric field should be same, and also at every point on the Gaussian surface we try to manage the angle between the direction of electric field and the area element to be either 0 degree or 180 degree or say 90 degree only, so that the calculation of the flux on that closed surface will become somewhat easier for us. Okay, so this is how we will be using the Gauss law. We will be taking this by an example. So the first application of the Gauss law we take is electric field due to a long uniformly charged straight wire of linear charge density lambda coulomb per meter. Correct. So this has been given to us, a long straight conduct wire here having some charge. This can be positive charge, this can be negative charge also here. Correct. So the linear charge density of the wire is lambda here, and we need to find. Let us take a point P here. Let us take a point P, r distance away from this wire, where we want to find electric field due to this wire. Correct. So we know electric field is a vector physical quantity only. So to find electric field, we need to find first the direction of the electric field due to the given charge configuration there. Then after finding the direction, we will be able to find the magnitude of the electric field also. Okay. So first, in this subheading I A right here, what will be the direction of the electric field? So direction of electric field we write first. So how to do this? Suppose I take this wire here. This wire I am taking again here, and I take a point P. So this is the point here. Then I take a element here, charged element here. Due to this charged element, the electric field will be directed radially outwards if it is positive charge here. So this will be the electric field due to this element. Then I take a symmetric element to the opposite side of this point O, and I say electric field direction will be radially outwards here, isn't it? So if when I resolve this in component form, since these distances are same here, this distance is same, so these distances are same, hence the magnitude of electric field at this point will be equal. So if when we resolve this in component form, we see that the components of the electric field along this direction, and we will be getting the components of the electric field along this direction. Obviously, if we take this to be is equal to theta, this will be E1 cos theta, this will be E2 cos theta, this will be E1 sin theta, this will be E2 sin theta. So these components being equal and opposite will cancel each other, and the only electric field that will remain is along that direction only. So I can say the direction of the electric field due to this wire will be radially outwards here. Correct? Because these two components will get cancelled with each other. That will be applicable for each and every element lying over this wire. So we can say due to a long straight uniformly charged wire, the electric field will be, direction of electric field is along the radial direction in a plane cutting the wire north. Okay, so this can be shown as, suppose you have been given this conductor here, this is the conductor here, and you want to show the electric field at the different points here, say at this point. So the direction of the electric field, and you can take any point here around this wire here. So if at this point you want to show the electric field, then you have to imagine a plane which will consist this, which will contain this point P here, and in this plane the direction of electric field will be in the radially outward direction. At this point also this will be in the radially outward direction. At this point also this will be in the radially outwards, and this will be in a plane which cuts the wire northward. Correct. So this is how we'll be doing this. In nutshell, I can say, due to a positively charged state wire, the electric field at this point will be in this direction, and at this point will be in this direction only. If this would have been negative charge, the direction is radially inwards here, and this will be in the radially inward direction also. So whenever we are supposed to draw the direction for the electric field, the points lying right of this wire will be drawing that in the radially outwards direction, and for the points which lie to the left of this wire, will be drawing in the radially outwards in this direction. Correct. So the direction of the electric field due to this charge configuration will be radially outwards in a plane which cuts the wire normally. Then we come to the magnitude of the electric field, and for magnitude of electric field we apply the Gauss law. Now we take magnitude of electric field, and you know, to find the magnitude of electric field using Gauss law, we need to choose a closed surface. That surface is called Gaussian surface, and in this case, to find magnitude of electric field, we take a cylindrical Gaussian surface. Okay, and let me tell you, if I draw the cylindrical Gaussian surface here, this will be, try to draw the Gaussian surface using dotted lines only. This will be the Gaussian surface I have taken. This I put this as S here. Correct. So at the different points, now you can see this surface can be divided into three surfaces here. This circular part is known as S1. This can be termed as S2, and this can be termed as S3, the curved surface of the cylinder. Correct. So to find the electric flux through the closed surface, you need to choose a very small area element, so that applying the formula of electric flux, we will be finding the electric flux from the surfaces here. So we take three different area elements here. Let this is the very small area element I am taking here. Then I take a small area element here also, and then I take a small area element here also. Correct. So you can say, what is the, show the direction of area first here. So area will be always along the outward normal. This is the area, direction of the area ds1. This magnitude is ds1 here. This will be the direction of the area ds2 here, and this will be the direction of the area element ds3 here. Radially outward I have shown the area elements. Then comes, what is the direction of the electric field at this area elements here. Then you have done that from the part A, it will be always radially outwards here. So what I do is, I show the direction of electric field here. So the direction of the electric field at this area element, if I draw here the direction, this will be E1 dash. This I direction show E dash. We know E dash and E dash we take here. Correct. The direction of the electric field. And here I take the electric field at this point to be E, and that will be also radially outwards here. So you can see, electric field direction is always radially outwards here. Ye bhi outwards hoga, this also outwards, and this also outwards. If we would have taken the area element here, then direction would be in this direction here. Correct. So now the very simple question, the common question arises, why it's E dash here and here E? Since we assume that these area elements are at different distance from this wire here, so we think
that the electric field magnitude can be different at three different points. And that's why here I have put E dash and here I have put E. Correct? So now on this closed surface S, we will be applying the Gauss law to find the electric field at this point P here. Then comes the point, okay, first we write what is Gauss law here. So right here, now using Gauss law, and you know Gauss law is electric flux phi is equal to its qin upon epsilon 0. This we have here, isn't it? So phi will be, since phi through the surface S, let me write here. Now the flux, this S can be divided into three different surfaces, and electric flux is a scalar physical quantity. So the flux through this whole surface will be the sum of the flux through the three different surfaces here. So this phi S can be written as flux through S1, flux through S2 and flux through S3 here, and this becomes qin upon epsilon 1. Correct. Now we write the formula for the flux. We know the formula for the flux is E dot ds, dot product of electric field and the area element. So angle between the two here is 90 degree, you can see. So I write first summation of E dash dot ds1, then we write this becomes summation of E dot E dash dot ds2, and for phi s3 I write summation of E dot ds3 is equal to qin upon epsilon 0. This I have written. We will be summing over all the area elements over the surface here. Now you tell me, what is the angle between E and ds1? We say it's 90 degree. Here also it's 90, here it will be 0 degree. So this will become summation of E dash ds1 cos 90 degree plus summation of E dash ds2 cos 90 degree plus summation of E ds3 cos 0 degree, and this becomes qin upon epsilon 0. Then you see E ds cos 90 will become 0, because cos 90 is 0. So this is 0 plus 0 plus. Now this electric field is constant at every point on this curved surface of the cylindrical Gaussian surface. Why? Because each and every point is at equal distance from the wire here, if the wire is at the axis of this cylinder here. Correct. So what we do is, we can take E out of this cylindrical summation sign only. So we take this out of the summation sign, this becomes ds3 is equal to. Now comes, what is charge enclosed by this Gaussian cylinder here, Gaussian surface here. So if the length of this Gaussian surface, we take this to be is equal to L. It can be anything, you can take this to be equal to H also. So if I take this equal to L only, and the linear charge density of the wire is lambda here, so you can always tell that if the lambda is the linear charge density of this wire, then the charge enclosed by this cylindrical surface will be lambda L. So we write this qin here, that is the charge enclosed by the surface, to be is equal to lambda L, and it becomes epsilon 0. Okay. So then you tell me, this becomes E ds3, which implies E and summation of ds3, and you tell me this summation of ds3 will be the total surface area of the curved surface of the cylinder here, and total curved surface of the cylinder is 2πRh, and since we have taken the length to be L here, and radius of the cylinder will be R without any doubt, this will be is equal to R here, we have written this R here. So we write this ds3 as E into this summation of ds3 will be is equal to 2πRL. Okay, so this 2πRL becomes is equal to lambda L upon epsilon 0, and this becomes E is equal to lambda upon, L will get cancelled with L, lambda upon 2πε0R. So this we get the magnitude of the electric field, and this will be written as can write this as, this becomes the first expression here, and if you multiply and divide this by 2, then this becomes 2 lambda upon 4 pi epsilon 0, and you know this 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is 2, so this becomes 2 k lambda upon. So this is the magnitude of the electric field, and you see it's inversely proportional to the R here. So as you move away from this wire, the electric field will decrease, and the graph between, if you are asked to draw the graph between E and R, then the variation will be like this one, E and R. So the variation will be rectangular hyperbola.
So this is, we will be showing this electric field due to a uniformly charged straight wire here, a long straight wire, correct? So this Gauss law, this the same derivation we have done in the previous class here, when we have used only the Coulomb's law to find the electric field due to a uniformly charged wire. And if you remember that, that comes out to be is equal to, E is equal to this 2 k lambda upon R. Therefore, if, now in vector form, how can you write this? So in vector form, the electric field due to the wire will become, this will become, say, this is the electric field here E, sorry, not electric field, this is the point P I take here, and along this direction I take the unit vector to be R cap here, and now this unit vector is in a plane which cuts the wire normally along the radially outwards direction. Then the electric field in vector form can be written as 2 k lambda upon R into R cap. This becomes the vector form of the electric field. So this is, R cap is the unit vector in a plane which cuts the wire normally in radially outwards direction. So this is the first application of the Gauss law, where by taking a Gaussian surface we are able to find the electric field due to a straight uniformly charged long wire.